وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى today we're going to be speaking about the ruling pertaining to القزع. قزع means what and what's its reality, what does it actually mean is what we're going to take inshallah ta'ala. First of all, let's take the ahadith and then we go to the a'immatul lugha, the people of the language, what they said, and then the kalam of the ulama regarding that inshallah ta'ala. And that is how I plan to go through this topic bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. This issue's question has come so much times, so inshallah ta'ala it's needed for us to speak about it. Al-Imam al-Bukhari narrated in his sahih min hadith Abdullah ibn Umar رضي الله تعالى عنهما that he said أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم that the Prophet of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم نهى عن القزع that the Prophet he prohibited the قزع في الرأس in the head. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he prohibited the قزع on the head. What does it mean? We'll come to it inshallah. Another hadith that have been Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated is that the Prophet ﷺ, Ibn Umar said, سمعت, I heard Rasulullah, the Messenger of Allah, ينهى عن القزع. I heard the Prophet prohibit from what? القزع. قزع is what? The cutting of the hair in a particular way, which we will see. Abdullah ibn Umar then narrated a third hadith, which is found in Sahih Muslim specifically. أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم رأى صبياً. The Prophet saw a young boy. حُلِقَ بَعْضُ شَعْرِهِ. Some of his hair was cut. وَتُرِكَ بَعْضُهُ. And another part of his hair was left. فَنَهَى عَنْ ذَلِكَ. Then the Prophet prohibited that. وَقَالَ. He says, إِحْلِقُوهُ كُلَّهُ. Either cut it all. أو اتركوه كله. Or leave some of it. All of these ahadiths have shown us that qaza' is haram. That the qaza' is what? It's haram. Haram means what? It's prohibited, not makruh, disliked. It means it is haram. And the ulama, they took this hadith at its zahir, at its apparent. From the scholars, there are many, but I'll just mention some of them. Khalal rahimahullah, he narrates in his kitab At-Tarajjul. Khalal, Abu Bakr al-Khalal, bi isnadin sahihin, an authentic chain, he said qala Ja'far ibn Muhammad. Ja'far ibn Muhammad said sami'tu, I heard Aba Abdullah, ya'ni al-Imam Ahmad. Ja'far ibn Muhammad, he said I heard Abu Abdullah, referring to who? Abdullah ibn Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. Abu Abdullah is Imam Ahmad. He said, I heard him. Ja'far ibn Muhammad is saying, I heard Imam Ahmad yus'alu an al-qaza'i, being asked about the qaza'. Faqala, Imam Ahmad said, naha Rasulullah an al-qaza'. He said, the Prophet prohibited the qaza'. Prophet what? He prohibited the qaza'. Also, Bakr ibn Muhammad, he said, an abihi, from his father, an Abi Abdullah, yani Imam Ahmad. And he was asked about the qaza', and then he said, huwa, it means, so Imam Ahmad gives us the meaning of what qaza' is. He said, it means, an yuhlaqa ba'du shari, that some of the hair is cut, wa yutraka ba'dahu, and some of it is left. And some of it is what? Is left. The reason why the qaza' is prohibited, and some of the scholars actually stated it, it is because it's tashabbuhu bil kuffar, it is imitating the disbelievers. And the usat, and the wrongdoers, and the criminals, in the way that they see it look like. And as you know, all know, من تشبه بقوم, anyone who imitates a group of people, فهو منهم, he is from them. The Prophet told us, عليه الصلاة والسلام, جُعِلَ الذُّلُّ Humiliation has been placed upon. وَالصَّغَارُ Humiliation and degrading has been placed upon. عَلَى مَنْ خَالَفَ أَمْرِي Anyone who opposes my affairs. That's the مُبْتَدِع. Every مُبْتَدِع on the face of this earth, he is what? He is ذَلِيل, حَقِير, صَغِير. A مُبْتَدِع is always belittled, belittled. He is ذَلِيل, he is always seen low. قوله تعالى, the ayah of Allah, قوله تعالى, the statement of Allah, was the beginning, سَيَنَالُهُمْ غَضَبٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَذِلَّةٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُفْتَرِينَ الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا الْعِجْلَ سَيَنَالُهُمْ غَضَبٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ مُفَسِّرِينَ go to Ibn Jarir's tafsir. This ayah, the Mufassirin, they said that the people Allah is speaking about here, the Mubtadi'a have a portion in it. Humiliation and degrading is upon them. So every Mubtadi'a is a hero. وَمَنْ تَشَبَّهَ بِقَوْمٍ And anyone who imitates a group of people, فَهُوَ مِنْهُمْ He is from? He's from those people. Anyone who imitates a group of people. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said about this hadith, that anybody who imitates the people, he's from them. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said regarding the hadith in his kitab, اِخْتِضَاءُ الصَّلَاةُ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ لِمُخَالِفَةِ أَصْحَابِ الْجَحِيمِ He said, هَذَا الْحَدِيثُ This hadith, أَقَلُّ أَحْوَالِهِ The minimum of this hadith, مَنْ تَشَبَّهَ بِقَوْمٍ فَوَ مِنْهُمْ Anyone who imitates the people is from them. The bare minimum that this hadith shows is أَنْ يَقْتَضِ التَّحْرِيمَ تَشَبُّ بِهَا لِلْكِتَابِ The minimum that it shows is that it's prohibited to imitate the disbelievers. وَإِنْ كَانَ ظَاهِرُ Even though from the apparent of this hadith يَقْتَضِ كُفْرَ الْمُتَشَبِّهِ بِهِمْ Even though from the ظاهِر that this hadith it shows the kufr of the one who imitates the disbelievers. What did the scholars say regarding the qaza, the hair? What did they say regarding it? The a'imatul lugha. What did they say about its reality? I'm going to bring the statement of two imams of the language. The first one is Al-Hafidh Ibn Al-Athir Rahimahullah. Ibn Al-Athir Rahimahullah has a kitab called Al-Nihaya, the fourth volume, page 511. He says, in the word Al-Qaza' when he mentions it, he says, وَقَوْلُهُ وَمَا فِي السَّمَاءِ قَزَعَةً أي قطعة من الغيم وجمعها قزع ومنه الحديث أنه نهى عن القزع because this is what concerns us here it is أنه نهى عن القزع that the prophet prohibited from the قزع Ibn Umar's hadith he says هو it is أن يحلق that a person cuts رأس الصبي cuts a boy's hair ويترك منه and he leaves it مَوَاضِعٌ Some places. He lets some places be. مُتَفَرِّقَةٌ So it's all over the place. He cuts this place and he lets this or something like that. مُتَفَرِّقَةٌ مَحْلُوقَةٌ He cuts this part, shaves it or cuts it and he lets this be. تَشْبِيهًا بِقَزَعِ السَّحَابِ الْمُتَفَرِّقَةٌ Just like these clouds that are all over the place. That's Ibn Athir's statement. Al-Jawhari in his Sihah. Third volume. The Safha is 1265. He says, Al-Qaza'u qit'un, qita'un min as-sahabi raqiqatun al-wahidatu qaza'atun wal-qaza'u aydan. And this is what concerns us. Is, an yuhlaqa ra'su as-sabiyyi, is to cut the hair of a boy. Wa yutraka fi mawadu'in minhu sha'ru mutafarriqan. That some of the hair is left untouched on his hair. Wa qad nuhiya anhu and it's been prohibited. Wa qaza'a ra'sahu. تقزيعا إلى حلق شعره وبقيت منه بقايا في نواحي رأسه. This is what powerful point that explains it more is إذا حلق شعره the person cuts his hair وبقيت منه some remain from it بقايا في نواحي رأسه from the sides of his hair. So something remains. It's مهم. في نواحي رأسه The reason why that makes it a very powerful statement is whether that is cut or not, it doesn't matter, based on the language. That it even encompasses, as long as there's hair remaining, when part is cut, it falls under the qaza'. Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he says that it doesn't matter where it's being done from. Okay, it doesn't matter where it's being done from. And it doesn't even matter if it's a boy or a girl. It's for everybody. Qaza is for everyone. ولذلك الشيخ العلامة ابن عثيمين رحمه الله في الشرح صحيح البخاري the second volume page 583 he says وقد نهى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن القزع والنهي يشمل الذكر والأنثى that the prophet prohibited the قزع it encompasses the man and the woman he also said in الشرح رياض الصالحين the sixth volume page 382 he says القزع أن يحلق بعض الرأس ويترك بعضه ويترك بعضه سواء كان من جانب واحد أو من كل الجوانب أو من فوق ومن يمين ومن شمال ومن وراء ومن أمام فمتى حلق بعض الرأس وترك بعضه فهذا قزع وقد نهى النبي وقد نهى عنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So the قزع is what? Some of the hair is left, some of it is cut, and some of it is left. Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen says, whether it be from one side. Or whether it be from all of the corners, whether it be from the top, whether it be from the right, whether it be from the left, whether it be from the back, whether it be from the front. فَمَتَى حُلِقَ بَعْضُ الرَّاسِ Whenever some of the hair is shaven, وَتُرِكَ بَعْضُهُ and some of it is left, فَهَذَا قَزَعٌ وَقَدْ نَهَى عَنْهُ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وسلم. The Prophet prohibited it. The Prophet what? He prohibited it, عليه الصلاة والسلام. Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen mentions the reason that is تَشَبُّ بِالْكُفَارِ He says it in Sharh al-Mumti', the first volume, page 168. He says, "التشبه بالكفار محرم." قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تشبه بقوم فهو منهم. وعلى هذا فإذا رأينا شخصا قزع رأسه فإننا نأمره بحلق رأسه كله ثم يؤمر بعد ذلك إما بحلقه كله أو تركه كله. Ibn Uthaymeen says after the hadith, "من تشبه بقوم." Anyone who imitates a group of people is from them. Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen he says. If we see a person قَزَّعَ رَأْسَهُ he shaves part of his hair, we will say to him فَإِنَّا نَأْمُرُ بِحَلْقَ رَأْسِهِ كُلِّهِ We will say to him, shave it all. ثُمَّ يُؤْمَرُ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ بِحَلْقِ ثُمَّ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ He's told to what? To cut all of his hair or he's told to leave it all. Either leave it all Or we tell him, since you've shaven it, make all the shame together. And then from the kalam of the ulama and aimatul lugha, that which seems to be apparent is, a qaza' is a picture I'm going to send you. Anything this is that is like this, is a qaza'. Anything this like this picture, any hair that's like this, inshallah ta'ala, I think it's better to put that on the video. Later, I'm going to send it to you, Imran, if you can put it in the group, yeah, you can show that this hadith, like shaka, all of these, is qaza, that's a qaza, any of those haircuts are qaza, and all of them are shaved, if you look at them, have you shared it in the group? Everybody just look at it. Has everybody seen it? Have you put it in the other group? You put it in our group? No. Oh, okay. Yeah, how's the sisters going to see it? قدر الله ما شاء فعل. We'll show it to you guys another time. That's a qaza'. Has everyone seen it? Yeah?
Yes, no.
That's a qaza. Anything like that, that's a qaza. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala knows best. Anything which I have said that was wrong is from me as shaytan and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.